Welcome back. It's a D-Day for students as the Tamil Nadu SSLC results will be declared tomorrow. The results are expected to be out by around 1:30 p.m. Candidates can log on to the website www.results.nic.in to access their results. Nearly 11.5 lakh students had appeared for the board exams under the Uniform Syllabus Scheme last month. Usually, Class 10 results are out in the last week of May, but this time the results were delayed as exam commenced only by the first week of April. In another scene, a person succumbed to injuries after he was attacked by a six-member gang in Perimet. It is reported that he was working with a private concern there. Our crime correspondent Salim joins us for more on this.
Since Perimet area is a bit sensitive, men in uniform have been deployed in front of the victim's house. In fact, the police say the accused persons and the victim are known to each other. The police also say that six people came in an auto, according to the eyewitnesses, and hacked the 38-year-old man to death. Out of the six people, three have been identified and three are yet to be identified. The police say all the six accused persons are still in the city and that they have formed three special teams to nab the accused persons.
For the second time in a week, student doctors struck work after one of them was manhandled by attendants of a patient at the Rajiv Gandhi Government General Hospital. Despite several rounds of conciliatory talks by Dean V. Kanagasabai, the doctors did not return to work. He advised the students to give a written complaint about the incident, which he said he would forward to the police. Meanwhile, an auto driver who was severely injured in the road accident admitted at the government hospital died as he wasn't attended by the duty doctors who were reportedly on strike.
டாக்டர்கள் மீது எமர்ஜென்சி வாட்ஸில் தொடர்ச்சியாக வந்து இங்கே இங்கே எம்எம்சிலையும் எம்எம்சியில் வந்து தொடர்ச்சியாக தாக்குதல்கள் நடந்துகிட்ருக்குது. மூணு நாளில் வந்து ரெண்டு தாக்குதல்கள் நடந்துருச்சுது, சரிங்களா? அதனால் எங்களுக்கு வந்து ஹாஸ்பிட்டல்ஸில் முக்கியமாக எமர்ஜென்சி வார்ட்ஸில் ப்ரொடெக்ஷன் வேணும் அப்படிங்கிறதுக்காக இப்போ போராட்டம் பண்ணுறோம் நாங்கள். ஒரு பேஷண்ட்டுக்கு எமர்ஜென்சி வார்டில் ஒரு அட்டண்டர் இருந்தால் போதும், கூட வந்து ஒரு அட்டண்டர் இருந்தால் போதும், அது வந்து ஒரு லா மூலமாக என்ஃபோர்ஸ் பண்ணணும், சரிங்களா? இந்த மாதிரி இன்சிடென்ட்ஸ் மறுபடியும் நடக்காமல் இருக்கிறதுக்கு கவர்மெண்ட் எதனா ஆக்ஷன் எடுக்கணும்.
The Delhi police claims to have cracked the case of the murderous assault on a Delhi MLA that took place yesterday. Four suspects have been detained for attacking independent MLA Bharat Singh near his office. The police believe that personal enmity was behind the attack.
और जिस तरह की हम लोगों ने several teams लगाई हुई थी, तो इसको हम लोग कल शाम को पकड़ने में सबको व्यक्ति के साथ सक्षम रहे और इसके लिए स्पेशल टीम के सॉरी स्पेशल सेल के मिस्टर सुभाष टंडन और उनकी टीम इंस्पेक्टर ब्रह्मजीत सिंह उनका विशेष योगदान रहा. उन्हीं की टीम के पास इन्फॉर्मेशन थी और ये टीम अलग अपने से तरीके से काम कर रही थी. फिर इन्होंने किशनगढ़ के पास इन चारों व्यक्तियों को दबोचा और इनको पकड़ा.
Moving on, West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee once again batted for Bollywood star Shah Rukh Khan when she requested Union Minister Vilas Rao Deshmukh for reconsideration of the Maharashtra Cricket Association imposing a five-year ban on his entry to the Wankhede Stadium. Shah Rukh Khan, West Bengal's brand ambassador, was slapped a five-year ban by the MCA on entering the Wankhede Stadium after getting into an alleged scuffle with the MCA after a match against Mumbai Indians in the recent IPL tournament. Congress President Sonia Gandhi has called a meeting of the party's highest decision-making body, the Congress Working Committee, tomorrow. High on the agenda are key issues like petrol prices, allied troubles and the state of country's economy. Finance Minister Pranab Mukherjee will brief the CWC on all economic issues including the petroleum sector. Apart from the CWC members, chief ministers of Congress rural states and Congress legislator party leaders from other states have been invited. India's Interior Secretary R.K. Singh has said that the government would offer assistance to Bihar if need arises to tackle the violence which had hit the state after the funeral procession of upper caste leader Brahmeshwar Singh alias Mukhya Singh. The chief of banned radical upper caste group Ranveer Sena was shot dead by unidentified assailants early on Friday morning nearby Ara.
केंद्रीय सहायता की आवश्यकता होगी तो राज्य सरकार से रिक्वेस्ट आएगा तो हम लोग जरूर रिस्पॉन्ड करेंगे.
सर दिल्ली में भी
अभी तत्काल तो कोई सहायता की मांग नहीं की गई वैसे भी यहाँ हम पर्याप्त सेंट्रल फोर्सेज हैं और अगर राज्य सरकार चाहे आवश्यकता पड़ेगी तो उसका इस्तेमाल राज्य सरकार कर सकती है. नहीं, आई डोंट थिंक सो. एंड दीज थिंग्स हैपन व्हेन देर आर सच ओकेजन्स वेयर पीपल गेट इमोशनली सरचार्ज्ड. दीज थिंग्स हैपन.
Another short break now. We'll be right back.